This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is video 5 in our series of solving equations with parentheses, and this is a doozy here, lots of parentheses, but we can do it. Just need like a big sheet of paper here. All right, so we have to do the distributive property I see 4 times. Alright, so on the left-hand side, we've got to distribute the 3 to both of those numbers. So we have 3 times 2x is 6x, minus 3 times 5, which is 15. Alright, next one. We've got to do the negative 4 to the x and the negative 4 to the 1. That gives me a negative 4x and a negative 4. Then we're up to our equal sign. And then on the right-hand side, we've got to do the 5 to the x and the 5 to the 2. Distribute that 5. So we've got 5x. 5 times 2 is 10, so 5x plus 10. And here's another place we have to distribute a negative number. Negative 2 to both numbers inside those parentheses will give me a negative 4x and a minus 6. It's really not hard. I think it's kind of fun, don't you? You just, you know, have more numbers, but they're doable. So now on the left-hand side, we want to simplify, and on the right-hand side, we want to simplify by combining like terms. So on the left side, we've got the 6x minus 4x. That gives us 2x. And negative 15 minus 4, that's going to give you negative 19. And on the right side, we've got 5x minus 4x, which is just x, or 1x. And plus, we got 10 minus 6, which is plus 4. So really, it comes down to a pretty simple equation. We'll just subtract x from both sides, and remember, that's the same thing as subtracting 1x, right? 2x minus x is x, right? It's 1x. It's not still 2x. And we also have to add 19 to both sides so that the variables are on the right-hand side of the equation. So add 19. So we're adding a negative x and a plus 19 all at once. So this gives me 2x minus x is just x on the left-hand side, since the 19 and negative 19 is just 0. And on the right-hand side, x minus x is 0. 4 plus 19 is 23, and we are done. So we didn't even have to divide both sides by a coefficient of x, because we ended up with x equals when we did this 2x minus x. So not bad at all. Of course, now we have to check our solution, make sure 23 really is the correct answer. Alright, we're going to plug in 23 for x and see if the left side simplifies to the same thing as the right side. So I'm just going to do the left side first. 2 times 23 minus 5, parentheses minus 4, parentheses, 23 plus 1. And let's just work on the left side first. We're going to simplify within each parentheses because we're doing order of operations. So I've got inside this first parentheses, 2 times 23 is 46. So I have 46 minus 5. And on the right hand side, we've got 23 plus 1, that's 24. So, and I don't mean on the right-hand side, just the next number. And then inside this parentheses, 46 minus 5 is 41. So we're finally simplified that parentheses. And 4 times 24, we could do that at this step or the next step. I'll just write 4 times 24. So then I've got to do 3 times 41, that is 123. And 4 times 24, that's 96. And then I've got to do 123 times 96. That's 25. Okay, right hand side. I'm going to put in 23 for x. So we begin exactly the same way, just putting in 23 in place of x. Okay, and we're going to simplify within each parentheses first. So the first one, 23 plus 2 is just 25. And the second one, we have to do 2 times 23, which is 46, and plus 3. Now I can go ahead and do this 5 times 25, that is 125. But I need to still simplify inside these parentheses before I multiply by 2. So that's 49. So let's see what that gives us. 125 minus 98, which is also 25. So yep, everything checked out just fine. So that means this is our solution, 23. So 23 is indeed the solution. It's the correct solution to that problem. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.